कैपिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट डिसीजन लेसन 16 प्रोजेक्ट इवेल्युएशन एंड लॉन्ग टर्म डिसीजन मेकिंग बिफोर इन्वेस्ट एनी प्रोजेक्ट यू हैव टू इवेल्युएट देयर आर मोर बिजनेस अपॉर्चुनिटीज अवेलेबल बट रिसोर्स इज लिमिटेड Therefore, most profitable investment opportunity should be selected. All the investment opportunities cannot be used. You have to select most profitable investment opportunities before invest. Therefore, in this lesson, we are going to discuss how to evaluate project. This is the theory. When business going to evaluate project, it can be evaluated based on cash flow. It means cash inflow and cash outflow you have to consider. Or based on accounting profit can be evaluated. Three methods can be applied. Based on cash flow, when we are going to evaluate project, payback period can be calculated or net present value can be calculated. Based on accounting rate of return, accounting profit, you have to calculate accounting rate of return. Therefore, in this lesson, we are going to discuss how to calculate and how to evaluate based on answer. It is important in the examination purpose. Think what we are going to select projects. There are more business investment opportunities available. Resources limited. All the opportunity cannot be used. Therefore, you have to select. This is the way. Right, now I'm going to discuss how to calculate payback period as well as net present value, accounting rate of return. Based on answer, you have to know how to take decision. Right, first one, see the example one. Read and get idea and see the requirements. Company is planning to purchase new machine. Its fair value is given 10 million. That is a market value. Not purchased yet. We are going to purchase. Then useful lifetime is given 5 years. And after 5 years, it can be sold for 2 million. That is a residual value. And given next 5 year, net cash flow is given. Net cash flow means cash inflow minus cash outflow. It has given. But in the examination purpose, you have to calculate cash flow also. That part I will discuss later. Now I'm going to discuss how to calculate and how to take decision based on payback period, net present value, as well as accounting rate of return. Given net cash flow year 1 to 5, and given discounting factor. Discount factor is given 10%. Required rate of return. Think about investment today, but benefit received after 1 year, after 2 years, after 3 years. Think about after 5 years. Today we have to incur for purchase machine 10 million, but benefit is not received today, in future. Think about today 6 million is not equal after 1 year 6 million. Today 4.7 million is not equal after 5 years for 4.7 million. There is a time value. Therefore, discount factor means there is a present value of 1 rupee. After 1 year, 1 rupee, its present value equals 0.91. After 2 years, 1 rupee equal, its present value equal 0.83. After 5 years, 1 rupee. Its present value equals 0.6. And given expected payback period, my expectation is given. And expected accounting rate of return is given. Those are relevant for evaluation part. First one, they ask calculate payback period. and recommendation based on its payback period. Think about payback periods. We are going to purchase machine, for that we have to incur 10 million beginning of the project period, year zero. Then year 1 to 5, it has given net cash flow in the example. Net cash flow is given. Therefore, for purchase machine, from the beginning, we have to incur 10 million, effect for cash decrease minus outflow. Then net cash inflow is given. Payback period means how many years used to cover the initial investment. Mulin invest karapu gana cover karaganna avurudu kiya kenawada kiyanne. Payback period. Therefore, year 0 to 5, net cash flow, then you have to calculate accumulated net cash flow. Accumulated means total value. Therefore, year 0, accumulated net cash flow equal to 10 million. Then after 1 year, receives net cash inflow 6 million. Therefore, accumulated net cash flow, this one plus this one. Therefore, here minus value, this one plus value. Therefore, this one plus this one equal minus value decrease 4 million. Then this one plus this one, here minus value decrease. Therefore, answer is a 0. Then plus. Payback period means how many years used to cover the initial investment. When accumulated net cash flow 0, that is time period we have to consider as a payback period. Therefore, in this project, payback period equal 2 years. Initial investment can be covered by using 2 years. Dapu sallitika avurudu dekak kenawada cover wenawada. Then there's recommendation. Think about theory part. When business going to evaluate project based on its payback period, expected payback period should be compared with calculated payback period. It has given expected payback period is given 3 years. And if calculated payback period is higher than the expected payback period, project should not be selected for investment. But if calculated payback period is lower than the expected payback period, project should be selected for investment. Now think about expected payback period equal 3 years, but calculated payback period equal 2 years. Therefore, calculated payback period lower than the expected payback period. My expectation 3 years. එන මට හිතෙනවා දාපු සල්ලි අවුරුදු 3ක්වත් යනකොට cover වෙනවා නම් මට මේ project එක හොඳයි. But actually, initial investment can be covered by using 2 years. එන මම බලාපොරොත්තු වෙච්ච කාලයට වඩා අඩු කාලෙකින් දාපු සල්ලි cover කරගන්න පුළුවන්. If calculated payback period lower than the expected payback period, then machine should be purchased. That is my recommendation. Machine should be purchased. Reason, calculated payback period is lower than the expected payback period. Think about this is the way you have to calculate and payback periods. Then think about recommendation. That is the first methods based on cash flow. Two method can be applied: payback period as well as net present value. Then second methods, net present value. Also same way, based on cash flow we have to evaluate. Think about year 0 to 5. And net cash flow same. Year 0, we have incurred for purchase machine 10 million. And net cash inflow is given. And discount factor, this is the present value of 1 rupee. There is a time value, investment today, but benefit received after 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. Therefore, after 1 year, 6 million is not equal to today's 6 million. After 2 years, 4 million received, it is not equal to today's 4 million. After 5 years, received 4.7 million, but it is not equal today 4.7 million. Reason, there is inflation, time value. Therefore, discount factor means present value of 1 rupee. Therefore, you have to calculate present value of future cash flow. 6 million received rupee value, its present value equal into discount factor. Therefore, cash flow into discount factor can be calculated present value. Therefore, this is the present value of future cash inflow plus value. It total amount equals 16,924. But initially, we have to incur rupees 10 million. Therefore, cash outflow equal 10 million. Present value of future cash inflow equal 16,924. Therefore, this one minus this one, that is the net present value. This is the present value and net value. Net present value. Present value of future cash inflow minus present value of cash outflow. Then net present value is positive. Then recommendation. Now think about theory part. If net present value is positive, project should be selected. If net present value is negative, project should not be selected. Think about investment today. Benefit received future. Therefore, investment rupee value should not be compared with future net cash flow, rupee value. Rupee value cannot be compared. Reason, there is a time value, inflation. Therefore, present value of future cash inflow should be compared with initial net cash outflow. Therefore, net present value positive, recommendation, machine should be purchased. Those are the methods we have to use under cash flow, based on cash flow. Payback period, I have discussed already. How to calculate and how to take decision, as well as net present value. Present value, then net value. Then think how to take decision. And last part, accounting rate of return, ARR. Accounting rate of return should be calculated based on accounting profit, not cash flow. But in this example, it has given cash flow. Accounting rate of return equal average net profit divided by average investment into 100. Average net profit. But given cash flow, think how to calculate accounting profit, then how to calculate average net profit and average investment. Right. Now see the theory part. When business going to take decision based on account profit, that part I will discuss later. Then this is the way we have to calculate average net profit. Average net profit equal total net profit each year divided by number of years. Total net profit. But here it has given cash flow. Therefore, when calculate accounting profit based on cash flow, given cash flow, they ask accounting rate of return. Therefore, we have to calculate accounting profit. Therefore, this is the important theory. You have to know how to calculate accounting profit based on cash flow. First one, annual depreciation should be deducted from each year cash flow. As well as residual value should be deducted from last year cash flow. Net cash flow is given year 1 to 5. It has available example. It has given example net cash flow. This is the example. From this value should be deducted depreciation. Depreciation cost value is given, residual value is given, lifetime is given. Cost minus residual value divided by lifetime can be calculated depreciation. That value should be deducted from each year cash flow. Reason depreciation is not included in the cash flow, but it is included in the accounting profit. We are going to calculate accounting profit. From cash flow, annual depreciation should be deducted each year. As well as residual value. Residual value is a part of cash inflow in the last year, but it is not part of accounting profit. Therefore, from last year cash flow, residual value also should be deducted. Then can be calculated each year accounting profit. Now see the workings. Cash flow is given. Annual depreciation, cost minus residual value divided by lifetime. Cost value, that is purchase price 10 million. After 5 years can be sold for 2 million. That is a residual value. Therefore, 10,000 minus 2,000, that is 8,000 depreciable amount. Divide by lifetime, annual depreciation equal 1.6 million. That value should be deducted from each cash flow, as well as important this one. Residual value, part of cash flow. It is input last cash flow, but it is not part of profit. Therefore, from last year cash flow should be deducted residual value also. then can be calculated total accounting profit each year. Take total value. It is relevant for 5 year periods. Therefore, can be calculated average net profit, total net profit. Total net profit divided by number of years. This is the average net profit. And it is easy to calculate like this also. Think about from cash flow, we have deduct depreciation as well as residual value. Depreciation, it total amount equal depreciable amounts. And residual value equal 2000. Therefore, depreciable amount and residual value, it total amount equal purchase price. Therefore, from total cash flow, deduct purchase price of new machine. Then can be calculated total accounting profit. Total cash flow minus total depreciation minus residual value. It means here total amount equal purchase price of new machine. Deduct from total cash flow, it is equal total net profit divided by 5. Therefore, total cash flow equal 22,000 minus 10,000, it is equal depreciation plus residual value, it is equal cost value. Then divide by 5 also can be calculated average net profit. Then average net profit, accounting rate of return equal average net profit divided by average investment. Therefore, average net profit all the calculators. Think about important, it has given cash flow, but we have to calculate accounting profit. You have to know how to calculate accounting profit based on cash flow. Now I'm going to discuss how to calculate average investment. Average investment, see the example. For purchase new machine, we have to incur 10 million initially. This is the initial investment. And after 5 years, it can be sold for 2 million. That is residual value, that is called closing investment. Therefore, opening investment plus closing investment divided by 2 equal average investment. Now see the workings. Opening investment equal purchase price of new machine. Opening investment plus closing investment divided by 2. Opening investment equal purchase price of machine. Closing investment equal residual value. Therefore, 10,000 plus 2,000 equal 12,000 divided by 2 equal, this is the average investment. Now see the accounting rate of return. Now can be calculated. We know average net profit, it is equal 2.4 million. Average investment also calculated, it is equal 6 million. Therefore, 2,400 divided by 6,000 into 100, this is the accounting rate of return in this project. 40%. 40% benefit received for average investment. Right, now think how to take decision. It is given in the example, expected accounting rate of return is given. Example, expected accounting rate of return is given 30%, but calculated accounting rate of return equal 40%. My expectation, expected benefit 30%, but actually calculated benefits equal 40%. When business going to evaluate, now think about how to take decision. When business going to take decision based on accounting rate of return, expected accounting rate of return should be compared with calculated accounting rate of return. Calculated mean 40%. If expected accounting rate of return is higher than calculated accounting rate of return, project should not be selected. Expect karanagana vadinam. If expected accounting rate of return higher than the calculated accounting rate of return, should not be purchased. But if expected accounting rate of return is lower than the calculated accounting rate of return, then project should be selected. In this situation, think about expectation 30%, but actual value equal 40%. Therefore, here calculated account rate of return is higher than the expected account rate of return. Therefore, machine should be purchased. Think about project evaluation. Capital investment decision. That is the last lesson. This is the theory. we are going to select. Before invest, you have to know which investment opportunity should be selected. Reason, resources limited. All the opportunities cannot be used. Before invest, we have to select. This is the way you have to select. It can be evaluated based on accounting profit and based on cash flow. When we are going to evaluate based on cash flow, those are the methods you would apply. When we are going to evaluate based on accounting profit, this is the method you have to apply. Therefore, you have to know how to calculate and based on answer, how to take decision. Important lessons.